In some videos I mentioned pre-emphasis and de-emphasis, but what is it? In this video I hopefully explain that. First we had terrestrial television with AM modulation, and terrestrial means earth to earth to a tower somewhere located on the planet. However, when satellite television started, they used FM modulation. So all these dishes are pointed to the satellite with FM modulation. And that's important. FM is different than AM. For FM modulation, we had a lot of satellite receivers that were very cheap, and even in second-hand markets for almost nothing or even free. The goal is to have the video signal from the receiver as much as identical as what is transmitted, so that you don't see difference. And if you look at such a video signal, I have here an example with the amplitude and the frequency, and the frequency is several megahertz, so even the shortwave band is somewhere here, and we see around the color burst frequency we see a peak, and this signal needs to be transmitted. So we have a video input, we have this signal, in a transmitter we have it completely flat, in the receiver we have it completely flat, and the video output is therefore likely the same as what we had as input. But you can forget that. And why? There's a lot of noise added, and that's a specific frequency modulation point. It adds noise to the higher frequencies. Maybe not as much as I draw here. So when you have the receiver, you would as possible option you have that you decrease the gain in the higher frequencies. Then you reduce the noise, of course. However, then you will not be able to have such a response that looks like the video input. It will look more like this, because you removed a lot of gain here. And we call this de-emphasis. So you remove the higher frequencies. With pre-emphasis, you do the opposite. You gain the higher frequencies, so the result will be that your video signal will be enhance the higher frequencies, and when you then have it in the total circuit, you have this frequency as input, you have preferred the higher frequencies, here you decrease the higher frequencies, and the result is the same. So instead of flat, you do this and this, resulting in less noise. We don't do straight lines, we do this in accordance with the standard, the ITU standard 405, also named CCRR 405. And here we see we have A, B and C. It depends what graph you use, depending on the television system you have. For the pulse system you have 625 lines, so that's B here, so here the lowest and here the highest, so the most aggressive. And then it looks like this. You have video input, you have this in the transmitter, we call it pre-emphasis, we have this in the receiver, we call it de-emphasis, and the frequency response is the same as what you put in it. And these are the schematics. It's really almost nothing, only a few components, and in the standard is mentioned that they should be within a tolerance of 1% to have exactly the wanted response. If we look closer to the schematic, it only contains a few resistors, a capacitor and a coil, and it depends on the number of lines, what television system, what component values you should use. So for the PAL system is this, you have some strange values, 300 ohms here. You can make it by three resistors of 100 ohm in series, 75 ohms, and a coil with some less than 10 microhenry. Some strange values, and I'm sure you will not get it within 1%, but you can do your best and it will still function. If you look at the de-emphasis, you see that the coil and the capacitor is switched. This is the de-emphasis, this is the pre-emphasis. So the values are all the same except for the capacitor and the coil, and that value is also different here. Impedance is 75 ohms in and out, normal in the video level. So you all do this in video level, not in HF level. Maybe another time some more about transmitters and our receivers with FM. So if you subscribe below, you will be kept informed about that.